Hello, welcome back to the channel. Today we are talking about a movie called The One. It is a 2001 epic science fiction action film. It was released on November 2, 2001. Before going to the main explanation, let's find out the short synopsis of the film. So, there are multiple timelines or universes in the film. 125 different timelines. When one of the other versions of you die, his power is distributed amongst the remaining survivors. The remaining ones get stronger, faster, and smarter. Gabriel Ulaw is a former MVA Multiverse Authority agent who killed another version of himself that was from an alternate timeline in self-defense, making the other versions of himself stronger. However, he became power-hungry and killed the 122 other versions for 2 years because he believed that if he killed all of the other versions of himself, that he would become a god. After killing Wallace and getting captured by Rodecker and Funch, Ulaw escapes the prison and is trying to kill Gabe Law, a police officer. In the meantime, Rodecker and Funch have to arrest Ulaw before he can kill Gabe, but there is a possibility that the universe could die or make Ulaw invincible. Let's see. Will Gabe be able to confront him before or after Ulaw ruins his life? The film starts with the narration informing us that there are parallel universes and that a force exists who seeks to destroy the balance so that he can become the One. We saw some policemen going to arrest a prisoner. It's more like they might shift the prisoner somewhere else. Then we saw that they were taking him out in a bulletproof vest. When they were about to get into the car, they were fired upon randomly. Due to this, some policemen were injured and the prisoner died. Later we saw the man who attacked the policeman come out, and it was the former agent named Ulaw. They began to shoot at each other. Ulaw flees the scene by hitting some policemen. In this scene, when this fight kicks off with the song "Let the Bodies Hit the Floor" playing in the background, the word "trouble" is immediately spelled, and Ulaw comes out of his shell to disarm an officer with a swift spin kick and knock him down with a hard punch. Ulaw then uses the officer as a shield against other officers shooting at him, with bullets moving in slow-mo as if you're watching a scene from The Matrix. After that, Ulaw proceeds to make quick work of the rest of the gang, and even kicks an officer out of his way like a soccer ball. At one point when he was breaking down, the police were chasing him, and then many cars crashed on the road. We see someone named Agent Evan and another agent capture him. Suddenly a beam of light falls on them and they pull the three of them up. And that was the MVA headquarters. And their Ulaw was captured and they throw him in their prison. We saw a conversation between Ulaw and an agent. Here, Ulaw asked him if he missed him or not. The agent replied, he missed the old Ulaw, not this present one. Then he was brought to a chamber where he was seated on an empty chair and many people were sitting around him and listening to his saintly discourse. There, one man came and threw some words to Ulaw. He said that if Ulaw kills the other 124 versions of himself, he will have the power of all of the 124. Follow this logic far enough, and retirement homes would be filled with elderly geezers who have outlived their others and now have the strength of 124, meaning they can bend canes with their bare hands and produce mighty bowel movements with scornful ease. But what does Ulaw hope to accomplish with his power? He might, the narrator suggests, become God, and thus, if killed, might bring all of creation to an end. With a guy like this, you don't want him getting in fights and taking chances. But the God theory is theologically unsound, because God works from the top down and did not get where he is by knocking off the competition. Maybe Ulaw is just a megalomaniac who gets off on being able to beat up everyone in the room. In a matter of time, maybe one of the differences between a good martial arts movie and one that is merely technically competent is that in the good ones, the characters have a motivation, and in the others, life is just a competitive sport. At one point, Gabriel Ulaw, once an agent of the Multiverse Authority, MVA, which polices interdimensional travel, seeks to hunt down all variations of himself in alternate universes. And so far, by killing 124 versions of his other selves and absorbing their life energies, Ulaw believes that he will become a super-powered godlike being called the One. After killing Wallace, the 123rd variation in the Anubis universe, Ulaw is captured by MVA agents Rodecker and Funch and taken back to the MVA headquarters in the Alpha universe, which we saw before. Afterwards, he is sentenced to life in the Stygian penal colony in the Hades universe. But Ulaw manages to escape with the help of his lover and teleports to the Karis universe where the last variation of himself lives. When Yulaw disappeared, the other MVA men arrived, but could not catch him. It was too late and he was gone. Later we see another prison scene where a policeman came to take another prisoner. That prisoner is named Ronnie. When police are taking him to the basement where cars are parked, suddenly one policeman finds that something is wrong. And the same thing happened here again. Someone firing from the AC box. And again it's Yulaw, and he tries to kill one policeman but fails, and again he flees the scene. In the next scene we see him shoot another police officer and say it's bad news as he shoots. What happened was that when the police officer went to finish him off, Evan and another agent arrived and the police officer was saved. Yulaw fled again. The last known variation, Gabe Law, is a deputy sheriff working in the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department. For 2 years, Gabe has been experiencing increases in strength, speed, and mental ability, but neither he nor his wife TK can understand why. While transporting a prisoner, Gabe feels Yulaw's presence in time to avoid being shot. Gabe sustains an injury after falling from a wall which Yulaw scales with ease. Rodecker and Funch arrive in time to stop Yulaw from finishing off Gabe. We see that Gabe came to the hospital with his wife and some colleagues were present there. Gabe was very scared and confused. As we see, the doctor suggests doing an MRI. But before going to do the MRI, Gabe gives his wife a locket and they hug each other. But Gabe thinks that he was hallucinating Yulaw as he didn't know anything about what was going on yet. Although unfamiliar with interdimensional travel, Gabe realizes that Yulaw is identical to him in every way. Rodecker and Funch track Yulaw to the hospital where Gabe is being examined. In the meantime, Yulaw does this in the scene at the hospital, using his own gun to deflect one of the bullets fired at him by the MVA agents. Yulaw discourages them from shooting him because if he is killed, Gabe would then be left as the one. His colleague doubts him, but they try to attack and fail as he escapes. However, dressed alike and identical to each other, Gabe and Yulaw's battle confuses the other police officers. Both Gabe and Yulaw manage to escape the hospital. But before that, an implied intention in the end, as one of the penal colony inmates mentions that Yulaw has a pretty mouth. But Yulaw reminds us that, to say the least, he won't be going down without a fight. Later we see that Funch goes into a 20-second gun porn spiel about the high-tech machine pistol he's carrying to Gabe Law. He gets off maybe half a dozen ineffective shots with it before it gets destroyed. Similarly, Gabe is a man who tries to keep his cool throughout. Yulaw, on the other hand, is shown to be aggressive and direct, displaying an extreme determination to become the one, as well as indifference toward those he hurts, especially in combat. We see that every move Yulaw throws carries an aura of ruthlessness, and once he is finished, he leaves with a stone-cold look on his face. Even though not once does he look back, nor show signs of remorse. The beginning of the film pits Yulaw against the LAPD after he kills Lawless, a variation of himself as we saw it before when we started. As the film progresses, so do Yulaw's ruthless tendencies. At one point he intercepts Delroy Lindo's punch with his chin, breaking Lindo's hand in the process. Later, we see Yulaw demonstrating his superior strength as he holds one motorbike in each hand and sandwiches a police officer between them. Any way you cut it, Gabriel Yulaw is that evil twin worthy of being a Marvel or DC supervillain. After that, the MVA agents deviated from their orders and split up. Rodecker pursues and fights Yulaw but is killed when Yulaw breaks his neck, disabling a bomb that Rodecker intended to use to finish both of them off. After that, Funch catches up with Gabe and explains to him that there are multiple universes with wormholes briefly connecting them at uncontrollable times. However, Yulaw sneaks into Gabe's residence where TK, believing him to be Gabe, agrees to hide him from the police. Then, she realizes that Yulaw is deceiving her but not in time to avoid being captured by him. Gabe arrives, only to watch helplessly as Yulaw kills TK. Afterwards, Funch finds a guilt-ridden Gabe and both team up to find Yulaw at the next wormhole. Later, Gabe and Funch arrive at an industrial plant, where they encounter and fight Yulaw. Funch is easily defeated, but Gabe and Yulaw are more evenly matched. Meanwhile, Gabe manages to gain the upper hand, but only seconds before the wormhole arrives. All three of them are sucked into it and collapse on the floor of the MVA headquarters. Later, Yulaw is transported immediately to the Hades universe after a failed attempt to switch places with Gabe. The MVA then prepares to send Gabe back to his own universe, where he will be arrested and put into prison for the crimes that Yulaw committed. In that moment, recalling an earlier conversation with Gabe, Funch compassionately sends him to a different universe in which Gabe can have a normal life again from when he first met TK. As the film goes on, Rogue lives up to his name and goes rogue while John tracks him. At the end of the film, we learn that Tom was left to die, but not actually killed. He overpowered Rogue and took his identity and disguised himself. Tom dies in unclear circumstances at the beginning. When Rogue reveals himself to be Tom, he shoots John and escapes. But you never see John actually being shot, and the scene switches quickly afterward. However, Yula spends the whole movie trying to ambush or incriminate Gabe. By the end, Gabe has survived everything and Yula faces him man-to-man. Meanwhile, Yula, now in the Stygian penal colony in the Hades universe, declares that he will still become the One and then proceeds to battle a prison inmate. In another scene, we see that Yula generally just shoots his targets immediately, having dispatched Lawless this way and tried to shoot Gabe several times, not to mention using a grenade. So, it's not clear why he gave up on it for the final battle, though he might have considered Gabe getting a handle on his powers and thus being unshootable. After that, Rodecker specifically forbids Funch from just shooting Yula, as by the time they get the chance, there's only two versions left and they don't want to risk leaving only one. However, Gabe is determined to deal with Yula personally, without any weapons, citing the fact that they haven't worked. Moreover, it's implied killing his first multiverse duplicate sent Yula off the deep end. So, whether it was the psychological trauma of being forced to kill himself in self-defense or the increased power is debatable, but by the time of the film he is insanely, ruthlessly obsessed with his goal of becoming the One, even referring to his other duplicates as wasted energy. Finally, the camera then pulls back to show an army of other prison inmates taking on Yula on top of a ziggurat. So, how was the movie? Do you like it? Then please like the video and also subscribe to the channel.